Overwhelmed hospitals have been the worst case COVID scenario for most nations. But this is horror on another scale entirely. The car park of a temple, where families who've been turned away from emergency rooms take their dying.
These are some of the most distressing scenes we've witnessed during the course of our reporting. And this isn't even a hospital. It's a Sikh temple where they're just helping out with oxygen and basic care. It's 45 degrees and it's so hot that the volunteers cannot even wear their PPEs. And people just keep coming and coming and coming. And there's just no room at any of the local hospitals for the people who are here.
In ordinary times, they distribute free meals here. But there's nothing ordinary about what is happening to these families. At least 12 people die outside this temple every day. Today, Preeti Gautam is praying her father is not one of them. She and her brother Vipin panicked when he could no longer breathe on his own at home. They tried taking him to different hospitals, but there were no beds. So they brought him here. The doctor isn't hopeful. He advises Vipin to keep looking for a hospital. But their ambulance driver is out of ideas. Help is arriving here slowly, in tiny amounts. India's deadly second wave has forced the nation's supply chain of oxygen far beyond its limit. And every avoidable death heaps more pressure on Narendra Modi's government. More accusations that he failed to prepare his country for this. Surjit Singh Sandhu volunteers here at great risk. Many of those helping out are testing positive for COVID themselves. He puts his faith in his temple. Hope comes from the patients they do manage to save. So scarce are supplies, people are flooding social media and phoning hospitals across New Delhi searching for canisters. Srinivas, president of the Indian Youth Congress, has set up a war room in his office. His team coordinates requests for oxygen, hospital beds and drugs. 100 volunteers man the phones. The few hours a night they do manage to sleep are spent in the office. Across the capital, Mohammed Shamim is also run off his feet. He's an undertaker at a Muslim cemetery, like his father and grandfather before him. He thought he had seen it all. Then the second wave hit.
ऐसा है माहौल तो ऐसा है जनाब कि हमारे जो कब्रिस्तान की जो ब्लॉक है कोविड ब्लॉक है वो तकरीबन सारा भर चुका है लेकिन ये है कि बस जो थोड़ी बहुत जगह जगह जगहें बची हुई हैं तो उन्हीं जगहों में हम जो उन जगहों को इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं और क्या आप देख सकते हो कब्र से कब्र मिला के खोदी जा रही है अब तो कि जगह को जरा सा भी हम वेस्ट नहीं जाने दे रहे
अप टू 20 बॉडीज अराइव ईच डे ही सेज फार मोर यंग पीपल देन लास्ट टाइम बाय द एंड ऑफ द वीक देयर विल बी नो स्पेस लेफ्ट हियर
हेलो
कॉल्स कम इन फ्रॉम 6 एएम अंटिल मिडनाइट
कोविड से हुआ उनका भी ठीक है ले आइए हां लेके आ जाइए हां वहीं ले आइए मैं जो भी कुछ हो करा दूंगा टेंशन ना मेरी टीम वर्कर हैं मेरे और भी स्टाफ के लोग हैं उन लोगों को भी जिंदगी में ऐसा कभी हमने देखने को नहीं मिला जो इस बार हमें देखने को मिल रहा है ना तो रोजे रख पा रहे हैं ना ही किसी तरीके से कुछ कर पा रहे हैं
बस वहीं से कपड़ा छोड़ो थोड़ा सा झुक जाओ
Crematoriums are running out of space too. Makeshift funeral pyres burn around the clock. The death toll in parts of India, both metropolitan and rural, is staggering. And worse still, the number of lives lost here so far is almost certainly vastly underreported.